Hello, stock investors. I'm Jerry Romine coming at you from Phuket, Thailand. And today's theme is don't panic, profit with these stocks. Yesterday was the worst day on the S&P 500 in a month. And today we're going to do a quick breakdown on what's going on in the markets. And then I'm going to show you some stocks that had strong days yesterday, even while the rest of the markets pulled back. As always, if you want to focus on hype, drama, and the Chicken Little syndrome, then check out another channel. But if you want to make money, whether the markets are going up, down, or sideways, then stick around and be sure to click the like, subscribe, and notification bell to keep this channel growing. And if you want to receive my live trading alerts, follow my stock portfolios, and get our daily hot stock list, then check out my Patreon. All right, now's the time to grab a huge cup of coffee and hang on, because this is not your normal stock channel. Barron's had a great article today. Why did the stock market drop today? Here are 4.5 reasons. Reason number one, COVID. 5 U.S. states hit a record number of infections, and other countries and cities are increasing lockdowns as well. And I know because I'm living in Thailand and it's happening here. With the lockdowns, it's only logical that economic growth is likely going to slow down. I try to stay politically neutral on my channel, but I'll share this. We live with the flu, the common cold, SARS, Ebola, influenza, and a host of other viruses, and it's time to accept that COVID is here to stay and life must go on. I really applaud countries like Singapore that want to reopen for business and recognize that life must go on and COVID will now be part of our lives, just like other viruses like influenza. I just created a COVID-19 poll and I'd love to get your vote and thoughts on it. It's normal for people to surround themselves with like-minded people, and a poll like this can be eye-opening since my audience is very diverse. Reason number two, July's retail sales declined 1.1%, which is almost 4 times higher than the expectations. The big concern here is that retail sales may have peaked and we could be sliding down a slippery slope. My own opinion is if we turned off the news and got back to normal living, the world would be a much better place and people would spend more money. Just think how many people want to travel and spend money right now, but do not because of the restrictions. For example, right now I have a Himalayan motorcycle trip in India that is on hold, and I'm ready to ride and, more importantly, spend money that will help local economies, and I know I'm not the only one waiting for restriction to end so I can travel freely. Did you know that Australia has closed their borders and it is nearly impossible for Australians to get permission to leave? I bring this up because world economies are connected and a worldwide recovery will help the US stock market more than most people realize. Reason number three, China has problems and they are not only struggling to control COVID, their economy is slowing down, which is seen in retail sales and industrial production. And if that is not enough, China's crackdown on internet and financial stocks are affecting a lot of Chinese stocks, including the EV stocks, which I happen to own a lot of. Reason number four, investors stopped rotating. The article takes the position that Tuesday's fall had to do with a lack of sector rotation. I think that is a bit of a stretch, but I'll let you decide. And reason 4.5, Afghanistan. The chaotic pullout from Afghanistan is unlikely to have an immediate material effect on the global economy, let alone the US economy. But it isn't difficult to see it negatively affecting sentiment that has already taken a hit from inflation and COVID. I believe Afghanistan does affect the market indirectly because Americans see a potential problem. And when you combine that with everything else already going on, people are just jumpy. It's kind of like if you're in the ghetto and a car backfires, you run for cover, not because the backfire is dangerous, but because you're already on edge with everything that could go wrong. Now that we've covered what went wrong yesterday, I want to quickly show you a few stocks that were up yesterday, plus these stocks have the potential to continue going up. And I know from experience, when the markets take a beating, the stocks that buck the trend often continue to go even higher when the markets come back to the green days. So with that, let's take a quick look at a few winning stocks that were not only up yesterday, but are also up at least 20% over the last 90 days. For the charts today, our goal is not to go in depth on our technical or fundamental analysis. I just want to show you some of the stocks that did really well yesterday, even while the market was tanking. So we're going to start off today with Aspen Aerogels, ticker ASPN, and all of the stocks, you can see them right here. This is our buy the bounce, and we've got an indicator that goes along with this. These eights kind of look like a B, and that indicates that the stock is bouncing back up off of the 20 or the 50-day moving average. And then these are all of the ones yesterday that were up.
Our first one here is simply Aspen Aerogels. You can see it bounced off the 20. It was up nicely, actually 8.3% on the day, so quite a bit. Then we also have our Momentum Dream Indicator, and you guys can look at these. And I just want to point out that on buy the bounce, it's very normal for the stock to bounce and the momentum part to be lagging. So it's quite common for our momentum to be down on both the Momentum Dream and on our MACD because it's going to lag a few days behind. Second stock is a name everybody should know, and that's Domino's Pizza, ticker DPZ. And looking at the chart, the first thing I see is what a beautiful set of railroad tracks. It's in a beautiful upward trend. Here you can see the 8, so this is a buy the bounce opportunity. We had another nice one right here, and every time it came down and touched that 20-day moving average, it took off up afterwards. Another one. This one didn't trigger because it shot up too much too fast after the earnings, but even on the earnings, they did blow things out with expected earnings of 285 and they came in at 312. So Domino's is another one to watch. Up next, we've got InMode, ticker INMD. You can see the 8 right here and it's bouncing. And one thing we include on this indicator is the range. So the EMA 20 right now is at $109.18. That's this blue line right here. And our 3% range means if it gets within 3% of that 20-day EMA, we're gonna be interested in looking at it as a potential buy. And it tells us what that range would be, 105 to 112.46. And the stock's current price is 107.61. And we can control all of these different variables in the settings. Next, we have Masimo Corporation, ticker MASI, and this is a great example of how the indicator works. First off, we can see we've got 4 days that it's been in the buy the bounce mode. That's all of these different eights here. And what I want to draw your attention to is the momentum. In the beginning, when it started, our momentum was going down, which is what we would expect. And we can see that by looking at these blue bars getting smaller and smaller. Our current momentum is up and it's just below the zero line. That's why it's in yellow. So the momentum commonly lags, and now the momentum is already turning around, and we just entered a squeeze, which could be giving us a buying opportunity. Our fifth stock is ticker ZTS, and I think that's going to be pronounced Zoetis, Z-O-E-T-I-S. Hopefully I got that right. And we can see we had a buy the bounce opportunity right here with a little 8, and you can see what happened afterwards. We've got another 2 buy the bounce opportunities that we're in the middle of. We've already got the momentum that's ticked up, and we are in a squeeze, and we just fired a buy zone, plus we're just about to have a MACD crossover. So this is a great example of how we can find winners even on a bad day.
All right, that's going to be a wrap for today, and hopefully you feel a little better knowing it's normal for the markets to go up and down and that there's always a way to make money in the stock markets. Thanks for watching today, and if you got anything out of the video, smash that like, subscribe, and notification bell to help the YouTube algorithm and to keep this channel growing. Have an awesome day, and I'll see you on the next video.